Well, everyone, there was no easy way to say this, but I'm pretty sure I'm going to be going back to my iPhone 10 from my iPhone 11 Pro. And I'm not even saying pretty sure because I already transferred my information, I already transferred my SIM. So this is my iPhone 11 Pro, and I've been using it for like the last couple weeks. I bought it first day at launch, and I'm not returning my iPhone 11 Pro. I can't, it's way too late. I'm still going to keep this. Obviously, I'm still going to keep it on my arsenal of phones, but the main issue that I have are basically no issues at all. There's really nothing that I hate about the 11 Pro. It's a very, ordinary phone. There's nothing too crazy about it. And at the same time, this is why I think it's okay for me to go back to my iPhone 10. And the biggest reason, and this is so petty, and you guys are gonna be like, oh, that's the reason you're going back. The reason I'm going back to my iPhone 10 is because of the storage variant. So I never bought the 256 gig variant of the iPhone 11 Pro, but my iPhone 10 was 256. And I don't know why Apple still made a 64 gig variant for the base model. That's the dumbest thing ever. But I wasn't even too sure when I bought the 11 Pro that I was going to keep it as a main phone or use it as a main phone. I was going to keep it, but I didn't know if I was going to use it as a main phone, but I ended up doing it. And now when I transferred all my stuff back, I had to delete so much stuff off my iPhone 10. And now when I went to my 11 Pro, I'm like running out of storage like crazy so fast. I'm having to delete so many things all the time. And that is the biggest issue for me. I don't really like doing that. And this is universal across all the board for any phones, whether you have an 11 Pro or you have an iPhone 10 or you have a whatever, or a Samsung or whatever, all those phones, storage variants are come and go. So I can't really hate on the 11 Pro too much for that. But this is my iPhone 10. I already transferred my stuff. I'm still going to be keeping the 11 Pro. Obviously, I have to make videos about it. I'm not returning it. And I'm pretty sure this is only temporary. I'm definitely going to go back to my 11 Pro at some point when I do eventually go get a 256 gig variant or 512 or whatever it is. I should have just bought those ones. I was too busy being cheap. I was like, I don't even know if I'm going to use it. I'll just get the cheapest model. I should have just went and got the most expensive one. I don't know what I was thinking. So I'll probably wait until the used prices go down a little bit, or I'll just go to the Apple Store and pick up a new one. I don't really don't care. But the biggest thing that I realized when I was using my 11 Pro as a main device was how good of a phone it was and how great and everything was, right? But it wasn't that crazy of an upgrade from an iPhone 10 at all. Like, it was very, very weird. The biggest thing that I noticed with my 11 Pro was probably Face ID. I noticed it being a little bit faster for sure. But the thing that I noticed, dude, it was like my day-to-day things, my day-to-day, whatever I did from day to day, it was completely exactly the same. It had no effect on anything that I did. The speed increase, I barely even saw one. It was faster, like smoother transitions and everything, but overall, it felt exactly the same. I'm sure if I went from like a 7, and I remember when I went from my 7 Plus to my iPhone 10, that was a pretty big difference in my workflow. Like when I was using my phone, when I was using whatever, there was a pretty big difference because I went to that gesture base and I went to everything. So that was pretty, pretty crazy. But now, like if I had to go back from my iPhone 10 to my 7 Plus, that would have been a pretty crazy difference, I think. But even going from my 11 Pro to like an iPhone 10s or iPhone 10, it's not a big difference at all. Even an iPhone 10R, like it's not a big difference at all. Like it was almost the same exact thing. And the biggest thing that I saw as well was battery life. I do think the iPhone 11 Pro does have the better battery life than my iPhone 10. But another reason why I wanted to go back to my iPhone 10 was because I had the Smart Apple battery case, which kind of works for the iPhone 11 Pro, but it really doesn't at the same time. So Apple hasn't made one for the 11 Pro yet, and I already bought this. I spent like $100-something on this. And for sure, the 11 Pro has a better battery life than the iPhone 10, but the iPhone 10 has better battery life than the 11 Pro with the Smart battery case. I don't really mind the hump that much. It's really not that big of a deal. I already bought this one. I feel like, you know what? I might as well take advantage of it. So until Apple releases their battery case, then I'll probably end up keeping my iPhone 10 because I use my phone. I don't even use my phone a lot, but sometimes I have my screen on. Sometimes I'm looking at things and my days are super long. Like I wake up at like super early in the morning and don't sleep till like late. So I need something to like last me that long without charging it all the time. So the reasons I have to going back to my iPhone 10 are super petty. You know, I do understand, but I'm not returning my iPhone 11 Pro. I'm still keeping it. I'm just temporarily going back to my iPhone 10, mostly because I don't really see that big of a difference besides the cameras and the like just being able to flex on people like, hey, I got the new one. They look at me, but I'm not really that type of person anymore. So it's not really that big of a deal. But my iPhone 10, dude, if you currently own an iPhone 10, just keep this thing, dude. It's a tremendous phone. Literally, I own the 11 Pro and I still don't really care about going to the 11 Pro, and I was using it. I still own it, you know? So if you're in the middle and you don't know whether you want to upgrade or not, there's absolutely no reason for you to upgrade from an iPhone 10. And one thing, I'll be honest, going back to the 11 Pro, I kind of missed Force Touch, man. I'm not gonna lie. I don't think it's that big of a deal. I think people were freaking out about it too much, including me. But after using it and after going back to it, the long presses and stuff are kind of annoying. And one thing that I hate the most about haptic feedback, I don't know why the heck I was looking up Evolution, but let's say like you had the keyboard open or something, right? On the Force Touch keyboard, you can Force Touch anywhere and move anything around, right? But on the iPhone 11 Pro, you can only hold down the space bar and then move it around, which was, we saw that on the iPhone SE on iOS 12, and then eventually got ported over to all the other iPhones. But I didn't think it was going to be that big of a deal, but it kind of was to me. So what I can tell you is I don't really care. I don't think it's that big of a deal going from an 11 Pro to the iPhone 10. If I was going to the iPhone 10 to like an iPhone 8 Plus or something like that, then I could see myself really changing the way I use my phone. But this is almost the exact same phone. If the iPhone 11 Pro was an 11 out of 11, the iPhone 10 is probably like a 9.5 out of 11. Like, it's super, super close. Very good phone. I love the iPhone 10. I love the iPhone 11 Pro, but I just need that storage. I need to go pick up a 256 or 512. I just don't have the time. Like, I literally should have just gone and picked it up. But at the end of the day, they're just phones. I love both of them. If you own an iPhone 10, I would say keep it. If you own an 11 Pro, I would say keep it. My use case is a little bit different than everyone else's, because most people would, you know, if they're going back to a phone, they'd probably end up returning the older one, which I've done before, but I still make videos on the 11 Pro. I still make videos on the iPhone 10. So this is probably temporary, but I do like the extra storage. I do like the battery case. And I don't think it's even that big of a difference for it to be like that big of a deal. So that's pretty much it, guys. If you have any other questions or anything, if you want to know, I mean, this isn't even that big of a deal. I might just be blowing it out of proportion. But let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Hit that like button. That would mean so much. But definitely hit that subscribe button. Every single subscriber that we get really does count. So it would mean so much if you guys could hit that. Check out the other links down in the description as well. Twitter, Instagram, second channel. Links are down in the description. But more importantly than everything else, I love every single one of you guys. Hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out till then.